Hey guys, and how are you? So we've got a basic conceptual tutorial today, so let's get ahead and start it. So this is episode 2, and it's going to be on this effect. It's a very unique effect, but it's very simple to achieve. So this series is to kind of help you to achieve and affect what you see on the internet or streets, whatever. So, wherever you see it. So, let's go ahead and first of all, you have to see the main elements done in the effect. So, on this particular effect, there's a woman in the background, and in this case, that the background's white with a grid over the woman, and some squares are transparent, but they make her skin or parts of her body or her face different colors. So, for an example, in this one it's purple, and in this one it is green, and etc. And the other effect that's done is the background's white, so it seems like the squares are only covering her face and then they disappear in the white background. So we have to kind of think of that. So when we have a subject, we actually have to take away the background, make it white. We're going to probably apply a little feather, otherwise we'll make so we make it nice and clear. And then we have to do put the squares over, and we have to change colors. So let's get ahead and do that. That a bit too difficult, so or unable to explain. It's pretty hard to explain it, but I'll try my best. I'll try and say that all again. So the background is white. So first, you need to, when you see an effect, you start from back to front. So it's more easier. So you start with the bottom layers and then you go on the top layers. So on the bottom layer, it's the background, and the background is white. So we need to make the background white. The second one is the squares. Second, the squares are white. No, the squares are transparent, but they also lead out into the white, like a seamless background. That's second. And the third one, the colors. So you need to change it with saturation, either a screen or blending modes, so you can get the effect. So let's get started on it. Let's go ahead and get your subject. You may have a different subject because this effect is able for any type of subject, and it is quite easy to achieve. So let's go ahead and grab this tool. I'm not sure if it is for CS5, CS4, CS3. I'm not sure. I think spot healing isn't. I'm not sure. But you don't need it. It's not necessary, but it does make your model look a bit better, or your person that you're doing. But it is for more photo manipulation. So let's go ahead and grab that, and let's just press on it like that. And all has it's gone. Now you could do your subject's eyes as they may be wrinkles. But let's go ahead, and there is a little dot there, there's a little dot there, there's a little dot there. Okay, and that's done. Not liking that black area. All right, done. So let's go ahead and press Control 0 or Command 0 if you're on a Mac. And let's go ahead and get started. So let's make the background white, as that's the first step. So we need to double click on the background and make it a layer. We're going to name the layer Model slash Background because the model is composed in the background. So let's go ahead and grab the Quicks selection tool and delete the background, make it transparent, then we fill it with white. Yeah, so let's go ahead and do that. So we're gonna grab that, and then we're gonna grab that. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Didn't open there, I just paused the video and I had to close it. So let's go ahead and select around your model on the edges and press delete. Now we're going to press Control D to deselect. Now we have this little area. We're going to grab the magic wand tool for working in the fine areas such as hairs. Let's press delete on that. Let's press Control D. Now the area is still there because it's hair, so it is pretty hard to get rid of. Let's just go ahead and erase that out with the eraser tool. Right, as you can see, the edges are a bit rough. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a feather tool. So let's go ahead and press Command O to fit back on the screen by adjustment. Now we need to make it on a new document now. So we're going to go to File, New. But first we need to see the size of this document. Image size. So it is this one by that one. So we're going to press OK, and we're going to go to File, New. Okay, press OK. That's our new document. Now we're going to make this white. So we're going to press that. Okay, now before we do the effect and cut this out, we need to make the background white. It's essential. Keep the background the same color which you're going to do the feather on. So if you're doing the feather on one side, you have to do it on the other side. So let's go ahead and grab the magnetic lasso tool. We're going to keep the feather around 15. Let's do 15. Now you're just going to click around your subject. Okay, once your model's selected or your person or your subject selected, press Command C and that's going to copy that. And we're going to go to our new document and we're going to press Command V and that's going to close it, and that's our model feathered. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go and, that's our model, that's good. So we're going to go ahead and close this because we are getting quite a lot of tabs now. Don't save that. And okay. So now once we have our personal subject, we have to organize the squares. For purpose, you can do small squares, but for this purpose, I will kind of use the big squares because it'll just be much more quick and efficient to show you still how to do it. So let's just right click and click and drag that over your person's face. Just kind of pick like an area and change it to screen overlay, I mean, so you can kind of see where the... You want them to be on the edges so you can achieve the effect. Anyway, so go back and change it to normal. And let's go ahead and delete that bottom layer. I don't know. Oh, wait. Yeah, you need that. And change it to model/background. Now, the way that I found that it's the quickest way to do this is you grab your quick selection tool and make sure you select it on your square grid layer. And then you select a square, for an example, on this one. And then you right click and do via cut. Now when you do that, you select back that square. You right click and then go fill. But to do this, you need to change your background color or your foreground color. So let's go ahead and choose that color which you want. And then you can right click and do fill. And then you can go ahead and fill it with your foreground color or background color. It depends which one's selected. And then press OK. Now, once you have done that, you go to your blending options and go to soft light. Now, that has done it. Now, let's press Command D, and you'll see what I mean. So, I'll go ahead and do that with a couple squares, and then I'll come back. I haven't done all of them, but I kind of need to see the white to kind of blend them in. So, let's go ahead and back to your square grid, and just press Delete. And you're going to delete the ones that you think that you don't need color. Sorry, that was my phone. Siri's gone crazy.
You'll need to unlock your iPhone first.
Okay, okay. Done. Okay, sorry. Press Control D. This one, I'm liking how if there's a color there. So let's go ahead and select that. Right click, no cut. Color to around blue. Select that, press Y. This one, I'm liking it. Okay. Now, white, so you want to kind of make it, so just press delete and they'll automatically continue out. Just trying to pick the color squares that you think that won't work. Yeah, this one won't work. Okay, that one, Control D. This one. Okay, so we have got ours, and you can see the remaining black spots. Now, so let's go ahead and fill those ones in, and then once you have done that, you are ready to rock and roll. So let's go ahead and fill those in. So I'll be back once I fill them in. Now, as you can see, our layer 13 is done. So it's all done. So once, yeah, so wait, layer 13. I can't see that layer. Right, now our square grid is done. So, oh yeah, we've got this one. Sorry. This guy's like, it's there. And then I'm like, no, it's not. Alright, done. So let's go ahead and kind of make it seamless. So now you're going to grab your eraser tool. I know this is going to sound... Oh yeah, so yeah, no. Eraser tool, and you're just going to kind of change the whites. The red-nosed reindeer. Okay, done that. Okay, done. Now let's go ahead and see this. Okay, so now they have done this and they have selected that, so the face is only showing through the squares. So now let's go do that. Oh, fine. So let's go ahead and merge all these squares together. It's going to be a brave move, but we are going to do it. Uh-oh. I'm going to keep this to self-light. Oh, yeah. I'm going to name this white. White grid. No, we have to keep that to that. Okay, now we have to kind of delete the model. So let's go ahead and do that. Delete. By just using quick selection tool. Okay, so we're going to grab the magnetic tool and we're just going to select around these squares. Now we're going to press delete. Uh-oh. Press Command Shift I to reinvert the selection and then press delete. Okay, press that. Oh my gosh. It's gonna be hard. So let's go ahead and back, and then we're gonna go and get the razor tool and we're gonna delete these. Put off the red. The red nose reindeer. Okay, go back to your white grid. We're gonna select the brush now, and then we're gonna use that, and we're gonna. Now we have to go to the model background and we have to fill it in black, but later, first we have to kind of feather this out. So you use a low opacity brush to kind of feather out. You're kind of like trying to like feather them out. Okay, now you gotta, we'll just try this, filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Just do that around the edges now. Now what we're gonna do is we're going to go to white grid and we're gonna go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And we're gonna do that. And now we're gonna go to white model background and we're gonna go to black and we're gonna fill that in with, oh my gosh. Now press Ctrl D, now we go back to here, and we select that, and we click on where it hasn't done it. A white grid, okay. Now we need to kind of size them up, so we hold Shift and select both layers, press Command T. So we press Command T and we resize a white grid. Press OK. Now we want to kind of move it. See, with the white right grid, you can do it correctly. Hey guys, I'm back and I've finished the final product. Now, in my opinion, it does look pretty good, so I'll just go into full screen mode now. So this is the final product, and it worked really well. I asked some people about what did they think about the effect, and they kind of really liked it. They said if the lines were a bit less thinner, then it might have been a bit more better effect because you could probably see the face more. It probably wouldn't divide it as much. But however than that, they said that it was a pretty good end product, and they said that it was a good job. Now, I did the speeding up at the end because I kind of went off track and I didn't do much commentary after that, and it's pretty hard to explain anyway, as every photo will be different. So for an example, a photo of someone in a different position and you want to take away different squares, it's really easy and simple. So I don't really need to explain it to you guys, as I know that you guys are smart enough or intelligent enough to remove some squares. All you need to do is make the background white on the layer of your subject. You need to make the background around her white, or he white, and then you can easily use the eraser tool to make the squares disappear and make the picture look seamless, so it only looks like she's looking through those squares. So I really found this concept tutorial good, but my explanation could have worked better. So yeah, because I had to cut the videos a lot. It was a bit edgy editing, but I'll make sure next episode will be another really cool effect. And I hope the main thing is I really hope that you guys enjoyed it, and I really hope that you guys like the effect. I think that it can be used in many scenarios. So thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, go and check out the other conceptual tutorials, as I have one on a really cool text effect. And there will be other concept tutorials being loaded up very soon in the recent future, because this is my series that I will be doing on graphics designing, concept tutorials. I'll be doing other series too, and there will be gameplay. This is a new channel, so we're ready to... We've already got the custom URL and stuff. And watch the video till the end, because the download links will be in the description below, and there'll be some cool music showing this effect. See ya, bye bye.